to meet Anya. My pronouns are she and her. And welcome back to my channel for a new video. I'm so excited to film today's video because today's video, as the title suggests, is a part two to my favorite underrated fantasies. And if you didn't know, fantasy is my favorite genre, so I love talking about fantasy books. And as per usual, before we get into these books, please remember to stay educated and stay informed and donate to Palestine. So, the first book on this list is called The Kinder Poison. This book is a YA fantasy following a young girl who's chosen to be the human sacrifice between three ales who do anything for the clown. This book is so good, and it's so underrated, and it deserves so much more hype because it was absolutely so fantastic. First of all, the world building was incredible, and it was so intriguing, and it was so well done. Second of all, the plot was so action-packed, and it was so fast-paced, and it was so good. Third of all the characters were well-developed. I really thought that the three ales characters would blur together, but each one of them is so distinct, and they were all so developed. The main character is also a well-developed, distinct main character, and I was so emotionally invested in her. This book is literally so good, and I ended up rating it 4 stars. In fact, I rated all of these books 4 stars, if not higher. So anyway, with that, I would highly recommend this book. The next book on this list is called The Never-Tilted World. For those who don't know, this is a YA fantasy following two young goddesses alongside their companions. So it has 4 distinct perspectives as they try to heal the broken world. I know that synopsis is rather vague, but I feel like it's better to go into this book with a little to no knowledge so that you'll get surprised with everything that happens. This book is literally so good. So first of all, like I said, there are 4 distinct perspectives, and there are 4 distinct, well-developed main characters, and I love them. This book is literally so good, and the cast of characters is so diverse as well. They're all Asian, we love to see it. 2 of them are sapphic, again, we love to see it. And 1 of them is disabled, so again, we love to see it. This book is literally so good. Even aside from the characters, the plot is so action-packed, and it's so fast paced, and it's so intriguing. The world building is so fascinating as well. This author is literally so talented, and the writing is literally so good, so that I would highly recommend this book and the sequel. So there you have it. The next book on this list is called Ink Island Glass. This book is a YA historical fantasy following a young girl who's from a world that was linked into creation, which, by the way, is so cool, and she must cross into the real world after her mom is kidnapped. This book is so excellent, and it's so well done, and I highly recommend it because, first of all, the world building is so unique, and it's so well done. The story is so interesting, and it's so intriguing, and it was so awesome. The plot was so action-packed, and it was so fast-paced, and it's just so inventive. This book is so well done. The main character is such a wonderful, well-developed, distinct main character, and I was so emotionally attached to her because I was so emotionally invested in her journey and her story because this book is so good. The romance was so well-developed as well, so we love to see it. The sequel was so good too. This duology is so underrated, and it deserves so much more hype because it's so unique, and it's so inventive, and it's so well done. So with that, I would highly recommend it. The next book on this list is called Dangerous Remedy. This book is another YA historical fantasy, and it follows 2 girls who are part of a group who rescue people who are about to be guillotined because it's set during the French Revolution. However, their latest rescue doesn't go quite the way that they expect it to. This book is literally so good. First of all, it's sapphic, so we love to see it. Second of all, the world building was so inventive, and it was so unique, and it was so well done. The sequel to this book was one of my favorites of this year, and I'm so excited to read the 3rd book because this book is literally so good. Like I said, the world building is so inventive, and it's so unique, and it's so immersive. Second of all, the plot is so action-packed, and it's so fast-paced, and it's so well done. so involved. The two main characters are so well developed, and I love their dynamic together, and I totally ship them. I love them so much. This book is literally so good, and it deserves so much more hype because it's absolutely so fantastic. And with that, I would highly recommend it. And did I mention that it's sapphic? Like, we love to see it. Anyway, like I said, I highly recommend it. The next book on this list is called Foretold. This book is a YA fantasy following a young girl who has OCD, and she discovers that she can see the future, so she immerses herself in a secret society of soothsayers. This book is literally so good. I know I read it about a month ago, so it's really not that underrated on my channel, but it's definitely very underrated in the fantasy world, even though it is a new release, so maybe that's why it's so underrated. But anyway, this book deserves so much more hype because it's absolutely so good. First of all, the world building is so interesting, and it's so unique, and it's so well developed. Second of all, the mental health representation was so good. Third of all, the main character is such a wonderful, well-developed main character, and I'm so emotionally connected to her. I'm so excited to figure out what happens next in the sequel, because this book was literally so good. The writing was incredible. The world building was so interesting. The characters were so well-developed. The romance was so well-developed. I'm so intrigued, and I'm so invested to figure out what happens next, because this book was literally so good. So with that, I would highly recommend it. The next book on this list is called The Prison Hero. This is another new release, so maybe this book isn't as underrated as I think it is, but it definitely deserves so much more hype. So anyway, if you didn't know, this book is a YA fantasy that follows a young girl who's been the prison hero in this death prison for the past 10 years. And when she volunteers to undergo a series of elemental trials that nobody else has ever survived, she's doing it to grant her freedom, because like I said, she's been the prison hero for the past decade, so she clearly has something worth fighting for. However, if you're wondering why she volunteers to do this, you have to read the book to find out. This book is literally so good. First of all, the world building is so immersive, and it's so well done, and I was so intrigued every single step of the way. Second of all, the plot is so action-packed, and it's so fast-paced, and again, it's just so intriguing. I'm so excited for the sequel to come out in October, and for the third book to come out next year, because this book is literally so good. The story, the romance, the characters, everything was so well developed, and I was so intrigued, and I was so invested. This book is literally so good, and like I said, I would highly recommend it, because this book deserves so much more hype, because it's absolutely so fantastic. So, like I said before, I would highly recommend it. The last book on this list, but certainly not the least, is called Daughter of the Burning City. This book is a YA fantasy following a young girl in a traveling circus city who can create illusions. And her illusions have always been just that, illusions, and therefore not real, until one of them is murdered. This book is absolutely so fantastic, and it's so well done. First of all, the world building is so innovative, and it's so inventive, and it's so unique. Second of all, the plot is so fast-paced, and it's so action-packed, and it's just so fantastic. Amanda Foody's writing is so incredible, and we all know that I love her the most, because I love her so much. I created an Amanda Foody book tag last week, in case you were interested. But anyway, her writing is incredible, because the way that she crafts her world, and her characters, and her plot, and her romances is so unique, and it's so well done. She is literally so talented, and this book is literally so good, and I think that it deserves just as much hype as her Shadow Game trilogy. So anyway, with that said, I would highly recommend this book, because it's so incredible, and it deserves all its hype and so much more. So with that, I would highly recommend it. So, in conclusion, please remember to donate to Palestine. I will also leave part one to this video in the description box below in case you're interested in more underrated fantasy recommendations if you haven't watched that video already. If you enjoyed this video, please don't hesitate to give it a big thumbs up. Comment down below the cactus emoji if you made it all the way to the end of the video. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel if you're new. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye!